welcome to the UU Treehouse. I'm Stephen Mead and friends to tell another story this morning that we can have fun with and learn something from. Today's story is Wilfred Gordon MacDonald Partridge by Mem Fox, illustrated by Julie Vivas, and published by Kane Miller. Once there was a boy named Wilfred Gordon MacDonald Partridge, and what's more, he wasn't very old either. His house was next door to an old people's home, and he knew all the people who lived there. He liked Mrs. Jordan, who played the organ, and he listened to Mr. Hosking, who told scary stories. He played with Mr. Tippett, who was crazy about cricket, and he ran errands for Miss Mitchell, who walked with a wooden stick. He admired Mr. Drysdale, who had a voice like a giant. But his favorite person of all was Miss Nancy Allison Delacour Cooper, because she had four names, just as he did. And he called her Miss Nancy and told her all his secrets. And one day Wilfred Gordon heard his mother and father talking about Miss Nancy. "Poor old thing," said his mother.
"Why is she a poor old thing?" asked Wilfred Gordon.
"Well, because she's lost her memory," said his father.
"It isn't surprising," said his mother. "After all, she's 96.
"What's a memory?" asked Wilfred Gordon. He was always asking questions.
"It's something you remember," said his father.
But Wilfred Gordon wanted to know more. And so he called a Mrs. Jordan, who played the organ.
"What's a memory?"
he asked.
"Something warm, my child, something warm."
He called a Mr. Hoskin, who told him scary stories.
"What's a memory?" he asked.
"Something from long ago, be lad, something from long ago."
He called on Mr. Tippett, who was crazy about cricket.
"What's a memory?" he asked.
"Something that makes you cry, my boy, something that makes you cry."
He called on Miss Mitchell, who walked with a wooden stick.
"What's a memory?"
he asked.
"Something that makes you laugh, my darling, something that makes you laugh."
And he called on Mr. Drysdale, who
had a voice like a giant.
"What's a memory?" he asked.
"Something as precious as gold, young man, something as precious as gold."
So Wilfred Gordon went home again to look for memories for Miss Nancy, because she had lost her own. He looked for the box of seashells he'd found long ago last summer and put them carefully in a basket. He found the puppet on a string, which always made everyone laugh, and he put that in the basket too. He remembered with sadness the medal which his grandfather had given him, and he placed it gently next to the shells. And next he found his football, which was as precious as gold. And last of all, on his way to Miss Nancy's, he went into the hen house and took a fresh warm egg from under a hen. And then Wilfred Gordon called on Miss Nancy and gave her each thing one by one. "What a dear, strange child to bring me all these things," thought Miss Nancy. And then she started to remember. She held the egg, the warm egg, and told Wilfred Gordon about the tiny speckled blue eggs she had once found in a bird's nest in her aunt's garden. She put a shell to her ear. "Yes, that's the way." And remember going to the beach long ago by tram, and how hot she got in her button-up boots. She touched the metal and talked sadly of the big brother she had loved, who had gone to war and never returned. She smiled at the puppet on strings. "Yes." And remembered the one she had shown her sister and how she had laughed with a mouthful of porridge. She bounced the football. to Wilfred Gordon and remembered the day she had met him. And then two of them smiled and smiled and smiled because Miss Nancy's memory had been found again by a small boy who wasn't very old either.